रेडी? 5 सेकेंड्स स्टार्ट. दिस कमेटी वॉज टू सबमिट इट्स रिपोर्ट ऑन द फर्स्ट डे ऑफ द 58th सेशन ऑफ द राज्यसभा दैट वॉज इन 1973. बट दिस कमेटी हैड टू वी ग्रांटेड 3 एक्सटेंशंस एंड द रिपोर्ट वॉज अल्टीमेटली अवेलेबल ऑन द 3rd March 1975. At that time, as we all know, the so-called JP's movement of total revolution was at its peak. Within 3 or 4 months, the national emergency had to be declared, and during the emergency, priorities had changed, and we could not just effect this desired improvement at that time, and we could not bring about this legislation. And then the Janta Rule and the Lok Dal Rule for 30 months, they were in power, but they too, although they try to pose to be the champions of the downtrodden and the workers, failed to deliver the goods, and that is why today we are going to consider the report of that committee that was presented to the government in 1975. Therefore, we are also equally responsible for not ameliorating their conditions and their plight. The committee had to consider 120 memoranda giving views and suggestions from various unions and associations, and 59 witnesses appeared before the committee, and that committee itself came to the conclusion that in various areas, even the barest minimum facilities such as arrangement for supply of wholesome drinking water, latrines, urinals, provision of qualified doctors had not been provided, though these amenities are a must under the Act. The Act has been there, but we could not enforce it. We could not implement it only because the employers did not want it. They did not want to give to the workers due justice. Inadequacy of punishments that are awarded, but during the act, is one of the main impingements standing in the way of implementation of various welfare measures. Courts generally take a lenient view of the offenses under the act, and they let off the employers who are offenders with lighter punishment, which generally amounts to a fine of ₹100. So the committee suggested amendment to section 36 of the act. An employer is required to provide these workers living accommodation, but generally, in spite of the fact that the government gives loans and subsidies to the employers for construction of houses, progress in regard to these constructions is very poor. As I said earlier, very unhygienic and insecure houses are there where these people have to live. Even compensation to the workers in the event of house collapse is not given. Stop.